Hi, everybody. My name is Steve Jarris, and I have been the lead writer on Saints Row 1, 2, and now Saints Row the 3rd. And I also was lucky enough to get a chance to write the Power trailer. So here's an exclusive behind-the-scenes commentary on some of the Easter eggs and fun stuff that's going on in the Saints Row 3 Power trailer. So here, a lot of people have commented on it already. In the beginning, we see Johnny Gad. The Saints are celebrities, so we have his the Saints Flow energy drink. And then Philippe Loren shows up to crash the party with the DeWinter sisters and his Morning Star. The selection of the song Power was actually something that was written into the script originally. So all the beats was timed to the music. We spent a lot of time massaging the track. So entering into the Saints penthouse, there's a couple things that you can go and notice. It's a little hard to see because the partygoer's thumb is obscuring the bottom of the invitation, but it says, "Welcome the Saints to Steelport," and underneath the fleur-de-lis is the text, "Sponsored by the Saints Ultor Media Group." It's our little nod to the fact that the Saints have partnered with Ultor, so they're throwing this like coming out party here in Steelport. On the website, a lot of people are talking about the DeWinter sisters being like these assassins, and they're really not. They're like really awesome personal assistants who are businesswomen and they're savvy, but they're not like killbots. They're really smart and savvy women, and that's a little misconception that I see get pushed around a lot on the forums. As you move through the party, there's a couple other saints there. There's Pierce is there with Gat in the beginning. Josh Burke is there signing his 8x10. There's Shondi. She's got a different look. She's a reality TV star now. The Saints bottle, of course, is a Saints Row branded bottle of champagne that gets busted up. And if you look really closely at his vest, he's got lots of little fleur-de-lis because the Saints have their own clothing line. The character typing on the sofa is named as Kinsey Kensington. And Agent Kinsey Kensington used to be a member of the FBI who has left the agency to go and help the Saints. If you notice behind her on the TV, Monica Hughes is on the screen giving a press conference, and she is now a senator. She's no longer a mayor. So here comes the player. It was hard to go and decide on a look for him because the player can be like anybody. We tried to pick a guy, just, you know, made him look, you know, young and cool. I think in hindsight, we might have made him look a little too much like Johnny Gat, but I still think he looks really slick. Angel de la Muerte with the tornado DDT. This is one of my favorite parts of the trailer. Both myself as well as the lead animator are big wrestling fans, and as a result, we try to go and subvert it whenever possible with some wrestling love. If you notice on the coffee table, there is a magazine with a Killbane Angels tag team partner on it, and the text is really small, but it says world class champion or world class criminal. And Killbane is one of the antagonists who used to work with Angel, and they had this falling out. And up here is Oleg Kurlov with a V, not an R. There was a typo in Game Informer, and now it's kind of become legacy, and hopefully we can go and squash that right now. Oleg is our 8-foot-tall, chess-playing juggernaut of Saints Row the Third. Stag is another part of the puzzle that the Saints have to go and deal with. It's not just the Syndicate, it's also Stag. The Saints are pretty much fighting a two-front war throughout the game. Stag does not play favorites. Stag is there to stop the gangs, and that means all the gangs. And here's our parting shot to those who stick it through to the end. Professor Genki's super ethical reality climax is one of our signature activities in Saints Row 3. And Professor Genki is the homicidal cat mascot of this show, who leads people on a delightful game show for fun, profit, and murder. And there's going to be a lot more Genki coming, and I think it's safe to say that you're not ready. Thank you so much for listening, and thank you for all the support that the community has given Volition and the Saints Row brand. We wouldn't be here without you guys. So, stay tuned to SaintsRow.com for more information. We're going to have lots of new stuff coming down the pipe. And be ready on November 15th.